was just trying to get, and then I thought I had to do my own makeup.
I told Jenna, I said, I will have makeup if I know what.
How's my lipstick?
Yeah, looks okay. Doesn't need any gloss or anything. I mean, I just
got that.
And I love the dresses,
right?
It'll look really good against them.
Yes, I didn't really. Hey, the universe was working today.
We were in sync. That's great.
We have to keep up the Elmo Award standards.
Yes. Hey, those are coming up.
So. I know.
So we already know we've got booked Christina Aguilera. That'll be cool.
Awesome.
She's still pretty hot, isn't she?
Yeah, oh yeah.
Okay.
Yeah,
definitely.
Well, you know, the voice changed it all for her.
I know. So
it changed it all
for
her.
Yeah, it brought her up to another.
And I think the problem with Christina, to me, she's the most talented singer of that generation.
Oh, yeah.
And I think the rest of them are just hating on her. Because they don't have her talent.
Yeah.
Britney and them do not have her talent.
She really does have talent.
She's the talented one.
She sang that one song that was a ballad.
Mm-hmm.
You know which one? Oh, my God.
Yeah, her voice is... I mean, when she did Mulan,
yeah.
They couldn't find a singer to hit that note. But see?
No.
But she was like a child, and she could hit that note.
Even Cher acknowledged that she had a great voice.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, she's amazing.
Yeah, she has had a year.
She's a musician. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And on top of everything else, she is a totally trained musician.
A lot of people would be surprised to learn that I was actually born and raised in the community, but I think it is emblematic of how our community really has been rooted all across this country. And I know that we have large populations in certain states like California, Texas, Florida, but the reality is that Latinos have been present across this country in different communities for generations. And my family was established in Kansas City, Kansas, in the early 1950s. And for me, to know that we had a Mexican-American community in many ways tied to the railroads and the workforce that was needed to support the railroads. There was a steel plant in Kansas City, Kansas. And there were the stockyards. And so those were the primary areas where many of the folks in our community were working. And my dad ended up working in the steel plant in Kansas City, Kansas. And we were part of a Mexican-American community. And central to that community was our church. And I guess in many ways, my faith has been a strong element in my life. And for me to see that the church was such a central part of our community growing up, I also think is typical for many in our Latino community. So we had a lot of great memories, even though my family was not, we never had a lot of wealth or resources, but typical of many of our families, we saw all of our parents work very hard. And that was true for me and my family. And, we made a good life. My parents made a good life for their family, even though we didn't have the wealthiest of resources during those times. A lot of times, you don't know you're poor when you're growing up. And I think that's something that is actually an asset for our community, that we find great satisfaction in family.